Hey Capricorn, welcome to your weekly forecast for June 8th through the 14th. We're going to see what's coming up for you all with this lovely deck here, and we're going to pull an oracle spirit message for you all at the end with this deck here. Guys, even though this is for the 8th through the 14th, we have some really big energies coming in with the Sagittarius full moon, which was eclipsed. So these energies are going to be around for a while, a long while. We're talking 6 months to a year. So even though we're covering the period of the week ahead, a lot of the things that are going to be coming up in your reading are kind of like going to be an ongoing theme. So this is, in some ways, I'm just going to go ahead and say timeless, or at least it's going to be applicable for quite some time. So we're going to see how these energies are affecting you, Capricorn, personally, with some of your personal chapters or adventures maybe moving forward. Alrighty, my dears, so without further ado, let's get in it. Alright, so you all are looking for purpose and meaning. This is Eight of Cups, okay? Eight of Cups is a card that, if I'm not mistaken, I think it may have come up for you guys recently. It may have come up for you either last week or the week before. I almost feel like I've talked about Eight of Cups with Capricorn fairly recently. I could be wrong, I could be mistaken. But Eight of Cups is a card when we're kind of looking for fulfillment and we're wanting to do something different with our lives. Which makes a lot of sense because this Sagittarius full moon is a card, an energy coming in that's making a lot of us feel very hungry for freedom and stability and safety and comfort and truth and the ability to have all these things and to achieve all these things being ourselves, like without having to edit ourselves or jump through hoops, like realizing that we're worthy and deserving of it now. We shouldn't have to beg so hard, or we shouldn't, you know, have to feel like someone's dangling some carrot in front of us. And so a lot of you might be in this energy where you're wanting something meaningful and you're wanting something that's going to make you feel a sense of, you know, an extension of yourself, something that's coming very naturally to you. Now, those of you that watch my readings pretty regularly, you've heard me talk about Eight of Cups as like the overachiever card. Because a lot of the times when the Eight of Cups comes up in my readings for someone, it's like it's somebody that's constantly setting a goal and they work really, really hard to achieve that goal. And they'll be happy for a little bit when they achieve the goal, but then after a little while, they're like, you know what, this achievement didn't make me feel the way I thought it was gonna make me feel. It didn't give me the satisfaction I thought it was gonna give me. I mean, I'm glad I did it, I'm proud of myself, but maybe I focused on the wrong thing, you know? Maybe this isn't what it's going to take to make me happy. Maybe I should have done the other thing. And so it becomes this cycle of like all these things you accomplish. And every time you accomplish something, you're like, but okay, something's still missing. So maybe I picked the wrong thing. Maybe I chose the wrong career. Maybe I need to go back to school. Maybe I need a higher degree. Maybe I just need to be married. Okay, now you're married. Well, maybe I needed to be married to somebody else. Maybe this isn't my soulmate. It's constantly escaping you in some way, no matter what you do, no matter what you accomplish. So this card is coming up to let you know that you can be happy, you can be fulfilled, you can feel a sense of satisfaction, but it's going to come from your connection, internal connection with your higher self, finding your spiritual center, and then everything else is going to fall into place. You're going to find the fulfillment, and then all the other areas of your life are going to fall into fulfillment. You're not going to find it outside of yourself and then come into fulfillment. So what does that mean? Like I said, finding your spiritual center. So think about the things in your life that give you a sense of zen. Okay, for some people, it could be music, it could be art. For some people, it's nature. I'm a water sign. For me, it's being in the water. There is nothing more healing and soothing and satisfying than being in the water, as far as I'm concerned, right? So it could be an element of nature for some of you. You know, it can be a few different things, but start spending time with whatever it is that brings you zen or puts you in that place of zen. And what's going to end up happening is you're going to start kind of going into what I call factory reset. You're going to go back to the original settings before the programming and the malfunctioning malware or like whatever, before all that stuff got implanted, right? You're going back to the beginning. You're going back to the original state. You're going back to your original you. And you're remembering. You're remembering why you're here. You're remembering what you're passionate about, what gives you a sense of purpose and fulfillment. Now, you're going to have to be patient with this process. Keep in mind, this is going to be energy that's going to be around us for a while. So, for me to have my factory reset in the water, it didn't happen the first time I started going swimming again. It was maybe after a few weeks, maybe a month or so. And it wasn't like the heavens opened up and the angels began singing. You know, like, don't wait for something, you know, out of the ordinary, like massive, you know, thunderbolts and lightning, or, you know, a big booming voice from the heavens. Don't look for anything dramatic. It's just this sense of peace that will find you, that you'll find this sense of peace, and there'll just be this inner knowing. Like, you're figuring it out, you're feeling it, it's making sense, the pieces are starting to come together. So it's not like lightning striking kind of big dramatic moment. Don't force the process. Just be in that peaceful activity, be in that zen, and you're going to have the clarity to figure out the next steps. You're going to have the clarity to figure out what fulfillment means to you, what it's going to take to feel fulfilled, okay? A little bit of homework. Your next card here is the Magician. Very, very nice. This is Major Arcana. And so you guys, maybe some of you have heard me talk about the Major Arcana. When the Major Arcana cards come up, you're coming into a new chapter. You're coming into a new phase. You're coming into a new time period. And what happens is that you're coming onto your path. You're entering a time period that you're going to really begin to accomplish what you came here to accomplish. You're going to begin, you know, learning the lessons and lessons and the things that you came here to learn. So anytime we're at this kind of a crossroads, we have our angels and guides coming up around us. And so some of you maybe have been feeling for a long time, oh, I think my angels are around me, but I'm not sure what they're trying to tell me. Sometimes they're just, you feel them around you because you're about to enter a crossroads. And they're like, all right, we're with you. We're walking with you through this, right? We're guiding you along. And so some of you have been feeling that this was coming for a while. And the Magician is about as above, so below. You're manifesting, you're creating. And we're coming into a new age right now, a new awakening. And there's going to be a lot of truths that are revealed to us, right? The Magician can also sometimes indicate illusion. And I'm telling you, Capricorns, right now, we're coming into a time where the illusion is really going to start getting lifted. We're going to see the truth. We're going to see the truth on a global level in ways we've never seen before. And so we're coming out of a dark ages in that way. We're coming into a new era, a new age of light. We're coming into a new renaissance. We're evolving and ascending as a human race. And so you, Capricorn, are going to be creating in your life on a personal level. You're going to be creating in your life a new way of being, a new mode of operating, a new way of operating. So you may be experiencing, or you may begin experiencing, a lot of coincidences or synchronicities. This is just letting you know that you're in the flow. You may be seeing repeating angel numbers, you know, 222, 555, 444, 111. You know, these are all ways in which you are in this universal flow. Now, one thing I can say, Capricorn, I know you guys have had a super rough patch. And I know I've said it before, and I'll say it again because it bears repeating. And although I'm not a Capricorn, I sympathize with you guys more than you know. because you guys are going through something very, very similar and you're coming out of it finally, but something very similar to what Scorpios experienced for a good decade or so, 10 to 12 years, right? And for Scorpios, it didn't let up till about maybe a couple of years ago. And some Scorpios are still recovering. And you guys are in a very similar energy, okay? So I know it's been rough for you guys. I know it's been very, very difficult. And I know some of you right now are feeling like, man, I thought I was finally getting out of it, and then I got hit real hard recently again, because we've had a lot of shifts happening lately. But I can tell you this from personal experience. The Magician card tends to come up at a time when Spirit is trying to let us know that it might seem very dark right now. It might seem there's nothing going for you, or there aren't options. But that's the whole thing about the Magician card. It's the magic that comes in. It's the magical changes. It's the creation, the energy of creation. So sometimes the Magician card comes up when we feel like there's nowhere to go but up. Like it can't possibly get worse. And so this card is affirming for you, or giving you confirmation that yes, things are going to be getting better and you're going in a whole new direction. So some of you are going through some kind of a cleansing in terms of all aspects of your life. Maybe even some of you are experiencing a financial cleansing. A financial cleansing will happen for people when they're on the verge of a career change, or when they're leaving some kind of work that feels icky to them or feels lower vibrational to them. It's like all the money that came in from that work kind of clears out, and then you have something new come in almost right after that clearing, and then new money comes in from new energy. That is something I've seen happen with a lot of people. And so some of you might be in this stage or phase right now. Do not be disheartened. Do not be discouraged. Okay, because you are going to be manifesting. You are coming into a time of creation. You are coming into a new beginning. Your next card here, Capricorns, is the Queen of Wands. And so the Queen of Wands is very much an entrepreneurial card for me. It's also a card that indicates somebody who is succeeding or making an income from their own talents, their own gifts, their own abilities, creating opportunities for themselves. So some of you may be entering into the gig economy. Some of you may be doing some kind of freelancing for a while. But overall, Queen of Wands is a card where I see her come up when somebody is about to make really significant progress in a really short period of time, because they're fed up, they're tired. Like they're tired, they're sick and tired of making tons of money for other people and bending over backwards and not being appreciated. And they're like, you know what, it's time to use my gifts and talents and abilities for myself. And you know, Queen of Wands, she doesn't have time for pettiness, for drama. She doesn't have time for revenge. She sets her mind to where she wants to be, and she gets there very quickly. So Capricorn, a lot of you are feeling very driven. You're feeling very driven for change, and you're just in this energy where you're like, there's no reason why I shouldn't have it. There's no reason, like I deserve this. And you're coming into this healthy entitlement, and you're gonna see progress happening in a very short period of time. That's something I see happen a lot with Queen of Wands. Now, I know a lot of times people are going to take Queen of Wands and they're going to go into like really like steamy romantic situations when she comes up. But those of you that watch my readings, you know that in the weekly forecasts, I set the intention to talk about career, family, spirituality, the healing process. And I try to keep love and relationship out of it, because there's so many love and relationship readings out there. I'm not anti-love. I'm not anti-relationship. I do the monthly love and relationship. So if you want more romance kind of reading, you can check out the love readings that are linked in the description after this video. But I just want to kind of emphasize here that in this weekly, you know, even if your focus is love and romance, just give it the chance to think about the other areas of your life and the other ways that Queen of Wands shows up for us, right? Because we're looking at the context of all the other areas of Capricorn's life, right? And so Queen of Wands, like I said, it's just somebody who's had enough and they really start to create opportunities for themselves. They become more bold. They begin aiming higher because they're tired of settling for less. And they hit the mark fairly quickly because they're so driven, they're so determined. The next card here is Ace of Swords. And this is really significant. Okay, now we talked about truth being revealed. So Ace of Swords can indicate, Capricorn, that for some of you, there is some good news coming. And there could be that something very positive is being revealed to you. I do feel for some of you, there could be a situation where a former employer is reaching out to you and wanting you to head something, wanting you to take the lead or take the charge in some kind of new project or new department or something. For other ones of you, this is going to be, I feel somebody's finally coming clean about an issue that's been really bugging you or plaguing you for a while. Ace of Swords is communication, clear communication, but also a very, very important message that comes in with Ace of Swords. For me in my readings, when I see Ace of Swords, it tells me that somebody is coming into a time where they're really, really clearing out old limited ways of thinking. They're clearing it out once and for all. So if you've had any kind of blocks in your crown chakra, that's starting to clear, that's starting to lift, and you're going to start seeing situations very clearly, and you're going to start seeing and noticing solutions that never occurred to you before. And you might be like, oh my gosh, like, why didn't I see that before? Why didn't I realize that before? One piece of advice I want to give you, Capricorn, it's really easy when you have this awakening and when you start seeing these creative solutions, it's really easy to start blaming yourself that, oh my God, I've wasted so much time. Why didn't I think about this before? I'm so stupid. That's the negative ego distracting you, stalling you, stealing your time, stealing your thunder, stealing your motivation. Don't let the negative ego do that. Just understand and know that for whatever reason, you weren't ready then. You weren't ready to know it sooner. You're ready to know it now. You know it now. Trust in the divine timing and just go with it. Go with the solutions. Go with the creative ideas that are coming your way. And don't get caught up in the woulda, shoulda, coulda. It's not your friend. It's not helping you to be in that energy. So we're going to go ahead and see what your spirit message is here, my dears. And as always, I encourage you to watch your moon sign and rising sign videos. Some weeks those may resonate with you more than others. You may need a private reading, which I'm more than happy to do for you. If you want to click in the Calendly link, you can schedule a private reading with me there. So your card here, my darlings, is Knight Ride, okay? Makes me think of the TV show Knight Rider. Did you guys ever watch that with Kit the talking car? And what's his face? God, what was his name? Michael, was it Michael something? No, it wasn't Michael. I can't believe I can't remember his name. Oh my, well, his name was Michael on the show, but I'm forgetting the name of the actor. Oh my gosh, Hasselhoff, David Hasselhoff, right? Was it David Hasselhoff? Anyway, I'm dating myself here. But you have Knight Ride, not Knight Rider, although that was a pretty cool show, but you have Knight Ride. Okay, so as always, I encourage you to look at this card and see what pictures and colors and things are jumping out at you and what it means to you on a personal level. This is a good exercise in intuition and taking personal messages for yourself away from a general reading. Now, the creator of this deck, you know, we're going to look at the symbolism that the creator gives us. For me, owls are a symbol of seeing through the darkness. It could even be ancestors coming in with messages for us, but seeing through the darkness. The elephants for me are loyalty, you know, tribe, finding kind of like a your herd, your tribe. Elephants, look out for each other. So those are all kinds of things I think about when I see elephants, but it might have a completely different meaning for you. The creator of this deck means to symbolize by this card, protector. It says wander in the night, big brother, and friendship. An elephant transports two owls on his back, a mother with her young bird child. Protectively, she has folded her wing over the younger owl's head. The elephant rides through the night, blowing stars up into the sky through his trunk. Connected with magic and wonder, the elephant is a protector, a strong shoulder to lean on in all times. Even during dark times, you can feel safe and secure beside him. Right? So we talked about this, right? This full moon in Sagittarius is making us seek safety, security. And a lot of you are coming out of a time of darkness, right? So Spirit's trying to let you know that Spirit is here, your angels are here, they love you, they're walking with you, they're protecting you, they're giving you courage through the changes, and that ultimately, you know, you're going to have a lot of blessings that are going to start coming in over the coming weeks and months, right? Stars for me are very much a message of following your intuition. So your angels and guides are guiding you through your intuition. They're lighting the way. They're putting the little pebbles on the path for you to follow, okay? Again, watch your moon, sun, and rising sign video. If you like a private reading, you can schedule with me through Calendly. I am also doing another giveaway for June. I'm going to pick one person to win a free 30-minute reading. And I'm going to pick one person to win a beautiful angel light bracelet. So I have the picture of it on Instagram and Facebook. I'm going to pick one winner from Instagram, one winner from Facebook, and one person's going to get a free 30-minute reading. One person's going to win the bracelet. And I'm going to just keep doing this every month. One person will win a free reading, and one person will win some different kind of prize. So if you're interested in that, I'm just going to pick the winner from the comments and the likes on the Instagram and Facebook posts. So follow along with the card of the day and the daily pick a card if you're interested in that. And guys, thank you so much to everyone who donated to Velast GoFundMe for Vibe Hair Salon. I promise you guys, I'm not going to like every single week come at you with another GoFundMe. But another GoFundMe was brought to my attention for a family, the mother in the family, you know, wife, mother, she's got two kids, she just had a little baby, she just had the cutest little baby, and she's, you know, mother to the baby and to a young man, and unfortunately, she's very, very sick with a kidney disease, so she needs a kidney. I don't know the name or the, all the details are in the GoFundMe, like the medical terms and stuff, and you know, I think she's like in stage 5. I haven't researched it. I'm not a medical medium, so I don't know if it's some type of cancer. I don't know if it's some other, I don't know. I just know that she's in stage 5 of the ailment. And so I felt very moved to help and to share their story. So if you are able to help out, that's in the community tab. If you just go and click on where it says community, you'll be able to see the post there. And guys, if all you can do is send a prayer, that is huge. That is massive. And I thank you for it. I'm sure the family thanks you for it. And I pray that whatever you give, whether it's a donation, whether it's a prayer, whether it's just sending love and light, I pray that you be blessed tenfold, that you receive it back coming at you times 10. So thank you, everybody. Thank you for watching, liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. I'm wishing you all a wonderful week. Take care.